Hi guys and welcome back to Nifty Challenge. So this is a new series I'll be starting about the indicator trading, and this is an important indicator that is we call as the MACD indicator. Now why I'm starting with this pattern right now is that very soon markets are coming to a higher regions, all-time highs. There must be many videos you must have seen on YouTube about indicators and a lot, but nobody tells you when to use which indicator. So I'll be clearly mentioning you how to use, when to use, and how to take advantage of these indicators. So first of all, MACD and RSI, both these indicators are used and best to be used when markets are trading at an all-time high. So on any stock when it is an all-time high, on the stocks when they are at a all-time high, on the index when it is an all-time high, that is the best time to use MACD indicators, MACD and RSI indicators. So what is an MACD indicator? The full form of the word MACD is Moving Average Convergence Divergence. I hope you'll remember it. Now this, why it is called Moving Average Convergence Divergence, because this indicator works on the moving averages. The moving averages depend on the price. So when the price changes, and why it is a lagging, see, all the indicators are lagging indicators. Why it is lagging? Because when the price changes, then the movement changes, then is the change that comes in the, then is the convergence or divergence that comes. So these indicators are always lagging. Lagging in here in the sense means that this will indicate you after it has already happened. Okay, so in simple words, first let me show you, this is an MACD and how to use it on your apps. On your investing chart, when you open this, this is the indicator tag. You just click here and type MACD, and this is MACD. If you switch on this, this is the MACD indicator that you get. You can use it at a 1 hour interval, at a 15 minute interval, or at a 5 minute interval, even at 1 minute, or smaller intervals. And see, these are the convergence and divergence. These are divergence here, a convergence here, which you can see in the market, and it basically tells you the movement in the market or the movement in the stock, which is based on the candle. A lagging indicator, as I said, and the good thing about this indicator that it is very precise and it is always correct. It is a very good indicator to be used in the market, although it is lagging, but it is very, very precise. So what are the important things that you note in MACD indicator? See this, there are two lines that you see here. First of all, let us see, this is called the zero line. This exactly at the zero where you see, this is called a zero line for the market. The blue line is the MACD line. The moving average convergence divergence line is actually the blue one. Whereas the red line is called as the signal line. I hope you will remember the important thing that you should know, ki what is MACD and how MACD is calculated. See, MACD is basically calculated by the difference of moving averages. Let me just mention it here. So what we do is the 26 moving average, which is 26 EMA, which we call, when subtracted, when we remove 12 EMA from this 26 EMA, what you get is the MACD line. So what you get by when you remove this 26 EMA from 26 EMA, when we remove 12 EMA, we get the MACD line. Now, if you don't know what are moving averages first, please just check it out. Make a Google search about it and you understand what are moving averages. If I start explaining the moving averages here, the video will go too long. And then what is the signal line? Now, this is how you get the MACD line. The signal line is basically plotted on 9 EMA. So the signal line is basically the 9 EMA moving line that you use here. Let me just keep it here. Now, coming to the most simplest part, let me not take a lot of time about you. So most simple thing is, how do we use the MACD indicator? Now see, this is a crossover line. The zero line is also called as a crossover line. And this MACD line, when it crosses below, in the crossover line, when below the crossover line, the blue line, which is the MACD line, crosses the red line right here, it gives you a buy signal. Very simple and very clear. You can try it, you can trade using this. Now we will just come to the candles as well. We'll come to a bigger chart first on a 15 minute period, so it's easier for you to understand. Don't use it above the crossover line for a buy part. That is why I'm just selling the buy part first. For the buy thing, use it below the crossover line when the MACD crosses. Look at this here. Right here, the MACD has crossed. as I told you, it is a bit lagging. So after this, on the second, on the third candle, you are almost seeing the crossover. But still, it is a buy once it is crossed, and you see the bullishness comes and you get an excellent buy here. Okay, that was very clear. So similarly, when above this area, when above the crossover line, the MACD line is crossing the signal line, that is where a sell indication comes in the market. You see right here, and then a sell comes in the market and you can go on a downside. Now see, how do you catch? Now I'm sure you must be thinking this mind, how do you catch in these area also it is crossing over, here also it is crossing over? How do you know that whether you're using it right or not, whether you get stuck on the wrong place in this area? So for this, you need to monitor the price movement. Always monitor the price movement with any indicator that you are using. So let us take for an example right here. You see, right here first, when we gave a buy, I will explain you better. See, when there is a crossover below the, when there is a cross on the MACD line, below the crossover line, you see the price in general is already going up. So this crossover is justified. That means you can take this crystal signal as a buy, because already the price was going upwards. The share price was already going upward at this time. And when the crossover happened, it is a double confirmation. You can go for a buy. Okay. Of course, you have to use the support resistances along, but I'm just explaining the indicators right now. Similarly, you see in this area, when this crossover has happened right here, the price has started moving down. So after this candle, when the price has started moving down, you can take a sell here and definitely you will get profits. Let us see in these areas so that your doubts are clarified. We zoom the chart more. So see, when this crossover has happened, there is no change in the price after that. This consolidating, this is where you avoid such things. When this crossover has happened, it has happened right here because it has opened gap up. You see, even when the cross has happened, see the blue line has crossed on the downward side. How do we buy? Just look at this thing. When we buy is when the blue line is above the red line. When the blue line is above the red line, it is a buy signal when it is crossing over. Of course, it has to be below crossover line. But you see here, again, I'll zoom in. This blue line has crossed the red line, so it is giving a buy signal going above. But still, you see this. You see this. The price is falling. The price is falling. So this is a false signal on the MACD. So I hope you understood what are false signals on MACD, and I hope you understood what are right signals on MACD. Let us take more examples to be more clear. You always use this with the price movement. Let's see in this area. The line has crossed, the blue line has crossed the red line, but the price is not moving. You will not buy, you will not buy, you will not buy, you will not buy. The difference is still there. The moment price has started moving upwards, this is where you can go for a buy, because MACD has already indicated you. This is how you use the indicator. Now you see here, the price has started coming down. The blue line has crossed, but even the price is coming down, so okay, you can sell, but avoid it because it is happening above the crossover line, especially on the buy side. But on the sell side, of course, you can take it. So this is where you see the price is coming down, coming down, coming down. This is where you sold for a small profit. Again, see, there's a signal for a buy above, but the price, when the crossover has happened, it is right after this candle, so you're not able to take here. Again, it is getting late. So always on a safer side, you should use this indicator below and above the crossover line. Below for a buy, above for a sell. I hope you've understood this indicator well, and I hope you can try it tomorrow or any time when you're using the markets, when you're playing on the markets. You can definitely give it a try. So always monitor the movement of the price of the stock along with the indicator's indication. Most important thing is that you should always be using the support and resistance lines along with using indicators. Indicators are of no use if you do not know the support and resistances in the market. So if you do know support and resistances, if you do have an idea about the resistances and supports, where they are, then if you use them along with indicator, they will definitely help you. I hope this video will help you. I hope it will help you in trades, and I hope you can slowly start practicing and getting better in your trade. Thank you so much. If you like the content, please share with your friends, and please like, subscribe, and comment. Thank you, guys.